Hi guys, my name is Dr. Arvind Kumar. I am the medicine faculty. Today, I will be going to discuss very important topic in the medicine, in the CNS, that is the topic of aphasia. I have seen many medical students, they find very tough to understand the aphasia. So what exactly is aphasia? Aphasia is a disorder of language that include difficulty or disorder in naming, difficulty in comprehension, difficulty in fluency or repetition. So, how to make appropriate diagnosis based on the language dysfunction? So, starting with the brain areas of language. So, the brain area of language, as you can see in this diagram, on the dominant hemisphere, that is a left side. Left side is the dominant hemisphere. So you can see the just focus on these areas: Wernicke's, Broca's, and conduction fibers, which is connecting the Wernicke's with the Broca's. Now just focus on this. These three areas. Remember, these three areas are responsible for repetition. So we ask a patient to repeat anything. Any one of these is affected, repetition will be absent. So if Broca is affected, repetition will be gone. If conduction is fibers are affected, repetition will be gone. Wernicke's is affected, repetition will be absent. Now, let's understand what is the meaning of a Wernicke's. So, Wernicke's area basically is the area which help in comprehension. Or you can just remember that Wernicke's area takes the input. Like if I asked a patient, what is your name? So, that is the input going to the patient. So, Wernicke's area take that input, comprehend that question, and that comprehension of Wernicke's area is helped by a transcortical sensory area. As you know, sensory is afferent or input. So Wernicke will be helped by transcortical sensory area. So transcortical sensory area and Wernicke help in the comprehension. Now, that information will go to the Broca's area through conduction fibers. Function of the Broca's area is output, the verbal output, or you can say it is a motor area of language. So, Broca area is helped by transcortical motor area. Transcortical motor area, so the function of transcortical motor and Broca is the motor function, speech output, which you can call it as fluency. So these are the functions of these different areas. Now if we look at how to make a diagnosis of those particular aphasias, so only look at three aspects of the language: repetition, fluency, and comprehension, and your diagnosis will be clear cut. So revising it once again, repetition is a function of Broca's, conduction, and the Wernicke's area. Comprehension is a function of Wernicke's and transcortical sensory. Motor output or fluency is a function of transcortical motor and the Broca's area. So understand, and you can make the notes here. First is this important flowchart. So first ask the patient repetition. So repetition can be absent or present. So first term, repetition is negative. So what you have to assess? You assess the fluency. So fluency can be positive or negative, fluency preserved or fluency absent. So repetition absent, fluency is absent, diagnosis Broca's. That is the only information that you need to make a diagnosis of a Broca's aphasia. Now, if fluency is positive, then assess the comprehension. If comprehension is positive, That means it is a conduction aphasia. So if only the conduction fiber are affected, Broca is normal, Wernicke's is normal, then in that scenario, fluency will be intact, comprehension will be intact, only repetition will be affected in a conduction aphasia. While if the comprehension is absent, it is a Wernicke's aphasia. Now go to the second arm. And in the second arm, if repetition is positive, patient is able to repeat the word, then look at the fluency of the patient's speech. If fluency is positive, that means it is a case of a transcortical sensory. Remember, transcortical sensory areas or transcortical motor area have no role in repetition. If they are affected, repetition will be preserved. So if transcortical sensory is damaged, so in that condition, the fluency will be intact. Fluency will be intact. While if fluency is absent, so look at the comprehension. So if comprehension is positive, that means it is a case of a transcortical motor. That means the repetition was intact and fluency was absent, but comprehension is intact. So it will just behave like a Broca's aphasia, but with the difference that repetition will be intact here. So it is a transcortical motor aphasia. While if repetition is positive, fluency is negative and comprehension is gone, that means it is a combination of both transcortical sensory and transcortical motor, both are affected. That is a case of a isolation aphasia. So with this simple flowchart, you can attempt any MCQ or any clinical case of the aphasia presenting to you. So hopefully you like this video on the aphasia. If you have any questions, you can put your questions under the comment section, and also you can note down the WhatsApp number on which you can put your doubts. Thank you.